kulingine. Kama ombi ishe.
Then also we do our very best Tumu Tumu Girls High School school anthem. That's will be our protocol as we start off. Then we also going out from there. We shall invite our principal to welcome our guests in this ceremony. Then our principal from there will invite Madam Ambassador. Then we shall be having some presentation from our guests. Then we do our entertainment from there during lunch. And then later on, in the afternoon, briefly, we shall be having a short movie, a documentary from Turkey. So that's how the program will be as of today. So, Michelle, I wish to give you this chance to start us off with the national anthem. And the Rangers, please. It will be done by the school choir. The national anthem will be done by the school choir. The girls who have moved very far, right now they are going to the regional competitions next week, and they have got very beautiful voices, so you know that they are going far. They shall be going far. Yes. So, beautiful voices from Tumu Tumu Girls High School. We are here now to give.
Thank you.
still at that position, we now do Tumu Tumu Girls School National. Also concerning this day, it's a very beautiful day. I can see now, you see Turkey is here. Turkey, can you see Turkey around?
Yes.
And I know most of us after this will be, after you get a speech from our visitors, you'll be willing to take a flight. I think even as at now, you join me to take the flight. Are you there at the JKIA?
Yes.
Are you there at the JKIA?
Yes.
Can you see yourself now going to Turkey?
Yes.
How many people are going to Turkey today? How many people are going to Turkey? Thank you so much. So all of us here are going to Turkey. And madam, I think your country is big enough to accommodate all of us. So, at this particular time, let us invite our principal. So this time I'll ask girls from this end, that you all rise again, you all rise, and you welcome our principal in a very beautiful way that I'm going to show you how we do it. Just rise, girls, so that you welcome our principal. All of us. Yes, let us rise. And we welcome our principal. Bye, say. Haya, karibu sana, mwalimu. Haya, we start with abarikiwe or we do which one?
Kabumi,
we are going to do it after this, But at this particular time, because she is our mom, she is our principal, we shall just do abarikiwe, then she does her speech. So, abarikiwe.
Abarikiwe sana.
Once again.
Abarikiwe sana.
Take your seats now. Welcome so much, our principal. Invite the guests and give us your presentation.
So, thank you very much, Mr. Mathenge. Our chief guest today, Her Excellency, the Ambassador to Turkey, the accompanying guests, the Tumu Tumu Girls family, good morning.
Good morning, Mrs.
Swami. Good
morning
once again.
Good morning, Mrs. Swami.
I want to say good morning to the two groups, the group from Turkey and then the group from Tumu Tumu Girls family. Good morning, Tumu Tumu family.
Good morning, Mrs. Swami.
Good morning, the Turkey family.
Good morning, Tumu Tumu girls.
this day, we are privileged and we are honored to have our guests today. Actually, it is a very, very special day for us as a family, a day perhaps we have not experienced for days. For us who have been here for 4 years, for 3 years, for 2 years, we have not had such an experience, and therefore this is a very special day for us. And maybe before I make my speech, I want to, in a very, very special way, ask Mr. Mathenge, in our own homegrown way of welcoming our visitors, to come and assist me to welcome the visitors in our homegrown way. Thank you, Mr. Mathenge.
Okay, very good. So we are going to do the two of them because that's customized to Tumu Tumu girls only. Borrowed from very far. I told you that I borrowed this one from China when I went there for a visit. And I want also to welcome our ambassador with the same. So we start with the osa, then we do kaboom. Sawa, then again, that's the rice for us. For the girls only, for the girls only. Thank you, thank you. So, we should come our ambassador the Tumu Tumu girls way. And let us see the osa, how you are going to do it. Very good. So once you say osa, osa, for visitors who may not understand our local language, osa means chukua, you pick something, then after that you give. Once I say osa, mala means flowers. So flowers we give them to the visitors immediately after this. So I say osa, you say osa, osa.
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 Osa mala.
Osa.
Osa mala.
Osa mala.
So now we escort Osa mala with a clap one. Osa. Osa. Osa mala. Osa mala. Osa mala. Osa mala. Magile. Osa mala. Mamulaki. Osa mala. Mamigi. Now from there then we do kabu. So we also in a very special way welcome you, a visitor, in the kaboom system. The kaboom system is only done in Tumu Tumu Girls High School. You never see it anywhere apart from Tumu Tumu Girls High School. The best gift that we can give you, Madam Ambassador. So kaboom! 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 Katia! 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 Kaboom! 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 Katia! Katia!
Thank you very much, Mr. Mathenge, for that welcome. Those are our homegrown ways of our welcoming our guests, and maybe we shall learn how you welcome guests in Turkey when you visit there. Thank you. So the next thing that I will do gladly, Madam Ambassador, this school has 1,056 students, and the management of those girls is in the hands of 42 teachers. We are not here, all of us, but I'll kindly ask the teachers who are here to introduce themselves, maybe just say their name and the subject that they teach. They are not very many, so it is going to take the shortest time possible. And I'll start with the young lady who is just here, who is an alumnus of this school. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Miss Maike.
Okay, I'm Miss Maike. I'm teaching Kiswahili and CRE.
Thank you, Madam Maike.
Geography, history, and I'm also in charge of boarding department. Welcome to our school.
Thank you, Madam Mutomi. We have the next lady.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, Mrs. Eshohe.
My name is Jennifer Eshohe. I teach chemistry and mathematics. I am the HOD Sciences, so the work that you saw outside there, I'm the one in charge.
Good morning.
Mr.
Gintao, Biology, Agriculture. At the charge of the stamps.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr.
Ndisho. My name is Mr. Ndisho. I teach history in CRI.
Guest today, Madam Ambassador, and your entourage, and the whole Tumu Tumu fraternity. Good morning.
Good morning, Mrs. Gishero.
Mrs. Bibiana Gishero. I teach music and English, and also the Deputy Principal of Academic Affairs. Thank you very much. Like I said, myself to the guests. Once again, I want to say I'm Jedida Mwangi, Mrs. and the principal of the school. In this school, we have two deputies. So the one who just introduced herself is in charge of the academic programs. And then we have another one who is out on apology, and she's in charge of the administrative programs. So our guests this morning and this day, I wish to once again welcome you to this great institution and say that we are privileged, we are honored and humbled to have you here. And we do not take it for granted. It is a blessing indeed. And before you, Madam Ambassador, we have, like we have said, 1,056 girls. We also have 42 teachers. We have 31 members of the non-teaching staff. We have 17 members of the board of management, and we have 20 members of the parent teachers association representatives. So this school is a public school. The sponsorship is by the Presbyterian Church of East Africa, but we are not really a church school as such. We are a public school, so even the funding, much of the funding comes from the government, and the other part comes from the parents. We are in the category of schools that are referred to as extra county schools in our country. Because we have levels, we have the national, we have extra county, we have county, and we have sub-county. So we are at the level of the extra county schools, meaning that we draw our enrollment, our students, from all the 47 counties. But the highest percentage is from Nyeri County. The other counties give us a small percentage. Now, in as far as the beginning of this school is concerned, or the genesis, this school, the history of this school can be traced back to 1908. 1908, when the missionaries from the Church of Scotland came to Nyeri and settled on this ground, where they set up a hospital, a church, a primary school, and later opened a teacher's training college on this site. In 1964, the college was phased out and the girls' school was born. And here we are, a girls' school on the hilltop. In as far as what we do here, the business that we do here is concerned, in our curriculum, it is divided into two sections. It is the curriculum, that is the subjects we teach, and also we have what we call the co-curriculum activities. In the curriculum, in our curriculum, we follow the normal Kenyan system, which is called 844 system, teaching a range of subjects, and I won't mind to name the subjects: English, Mathematics, Kiswahili. Madam, Kiswahili is our national language. Kiswahili, Biology, Chemistry, Physics, History, Geography, Christian Religious Studies, Business Studies, Computer Studies, Agriculture, and Home Science. Those are the subjects that we offer in this school. And at the start, the girls do almost all those subjects. Then as they graduate from Form 2 to Form 3, they select. But of course, we have those subjects that are, we say they are compulsory, Mathematics, English, and Kiswahili. Those are compulsory. And also, we encourage them to do the sciences. So in our institution, biology and chemistry are also compulsory, so that we can encourage our girls to pursue science-oriented courses. In the co-curricular activities, we have a wide range of them. As you see, our numbers are large, and therefore, for us to be able to cater for the interests of these girls, we have allowed for quite a number of co-curricular activities. We have sports and games. We have music, drama, and several clubs, the likes of debate, the likes of environmental club, the movements like the girls that you just inspected, the scouts, the St. John Ambulance girls who take care of the first aid in the school and even sometimes outside, and many others. We have a wide range of clubs. And this is for us to be able to help these girls to grow, to be able to serve other people globally. And it is timely, madam, that you are here to interact with us, and most importantly, to interact with these girls, so that as they continue with their studies, they'll be able to know that beyond the boundaries of Kenya, there are good things that happen out there. There are good people that live out there. And there are so many things that they can be able to do out there beyond the boundaries of Kenya. Of course, we are not saying Kenya is bad. We are saying that the world is not limited to Kenya. It is just one country out of the many. So I believe, and we believe as a community, that in our interactions today, madam, we shall be able to open doors to one another. First, to open doors for you and your people, that there is a home far away from home that is called Tumu Tumu Girls. You can always pay us a visit. We are going to open doors to further expose our girls to new experiences. We hope, and that's our desire, Madam, a ambassador, that we shall even go higher and have exchange programs between our girls or between our youth, our girls, Tumu Tumu girls, and the youth from Turkey. We hope that that is a possibility. We also hope that there is going to be some positive outcome in as far as further education is concerned. These girls, they are focused girls, as you saw in their presentation, that was just a sample. All these girls are capable of doing great things, and therefore we hope that even in as far as further education is concerned, we can have some kind of openings for them in terms of admissions in universities in Turkey and also scholarships. That is our hope after our interactions today. We also hope that we can also have an opportunity for some of them to pay a visit to Turkey and have a practical experience and exposure on what happens in that good country that is called Turkey. And we are also to welcome so that if there is any other way your kind office can add some value to our girls, we are open to that. And from our end, what we promise is to be productive members of our society, and where need be, if we have like that stage programs, we really appreciate, and I believe these young people can do a lot. Not only in Kenya, they can do a lot of great things, even in Turkey. And with those remarks, I wish to rest the case of Tumu Tumu girls there, and humbly welcome you to speak to these girls. I know you have a lot for them. And I believe that after we have interacted, something good is going to be born out of our relationship and interactions today. So it's my pleasure now, madam, to welcome you to speak to us. Thank you. Yes, we welcome her, again, the common Kenyan way, with three hearty claps. One to go. Thank you very much. Welcome.
Thank you very much. Good, I think it's afternoon already. Good afternoon, Tumu Tumu girls.
Good afternoon.
Esteemed Madam Principal, esteemed teachers, dear friends from Elimu TV who have been cooperating greatly with our embassy, and definitely dear, beautiful students. It is a real, real pleasure and honor and privilege for us, for my embassy, to visit you today and to know you. First of all, let me ask, how many of you know what an ambassador does? You know what doctors do, you know what teachers do, what does an ambassador do? I'm not going to ask questions, just raise your hand if you know. So. Definitely, I'm an alien to you. So let me introduce myself first. Ambassadors are sent by their governments, by their presidents, to foreign countries to represent their own country in the host country. That means I'm here in Kenya, sent by the president of Turkey with an assignment letter addressed to His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta. And my job is to strengthen in all areas and by all means the friendship and cooperation between Turkey and Kenya. With that I mean, you know, people, they may become friends, but this doesn't produce the conclusion that they will think the same way
in all areas. Sometimes even very close friends, they may have disagreements. And our job here at the embassy is to minimize those disagreements and to make sure that those disagreements do not create any clouds over the real and deep-rooted friendship that Turkey and Kenya have towards each other. So that's our main job. How do we do that? We encourage business people to travel. We encourage Kenyan tea to be exported to Turkey. We encourage Turkish clothes, which are of very high quality, to be sold in the Kenyan market. We encourage the Turkish people to know about Kenya and to know about the potential here, the economic opportunities here, the business opportunities here, and first and foremost, your beautiful nature, tourism, and wildlife. So we encourage the Turkish people to visit Kenya. And the very first step is, of course, promoting Kenya in Turkey. And you have an ambassador, Kenya has an ambassador in Turkey as well. So we cooperate in all these areas. Politically, we cooperate with Kenya to understand each other, to make sure that our governments join hands in multilateral organizations, international organizations, to contribute to world peace and to world stability. Culturally, we try to make sure that beautiful people like yourselves know more about Turkey. And the Turkish people, they also know about the Kenyan culture, which is very wide and diverse. This is part of our job. We issue visas. I think that is the most known face of an embassy. So we do multiple things. But the basic aim is all the same, to minimize disagreements and to maximize the friendship and cooperation. This is, in a nutshell, what we do. Today we are going to try to explain a little bit about Turkey to yourself, but unless you go to my country, you speak with Turks, you make friends with them, I think there's always going to be a missing part. And that is the most important part of a diplomat's and ambassador's work, to understand people, to try to learn about people, about their cultures, and even if they do some negative things, to understand the reasons why they act in that specific way, and if there is any possible way of finding a common ground instead of confrontation. That is the central part of what we do. You have here a great opportunity. The moment I step in this school, I can feel that you are receiving high quality education. And I have visited your exhibitions, all those experiments you have been doing. I have had the honor of inspecting your guard of honor. The thing I can feel is ownership, commitment, motivation, and discipline. These are very important values that will create a very good future for yourself. So you have every right to trust in your own strength. I'm sure maybe I will not be able to recognize you because you're so many, but I am sure one day I will meet among you some very successful diplomats, and we will work as colleagues. We will try to see how we can do good things for our countries or for the international community as a whole. And I can see it in your eyes looking at you today. So you have every right to be confident of yourselves. Saying that, you're all girls, and you should know that life is not always so easy, especially for women and girls. But when you look at the development of history, you will also see that women, despite all the challenges, like the extra challenges that they have been facing, they have gone a big way. You have Africa's first directly elected president, female president in Liberia. Look at what has happened in the United States. The election results didn't come to her favor, but the United States for the first time had a candidate for presidency. All around the world, there are females rising in every sector in life. So never stop dreaming. If you feel that your capacity, your potential is this much, dream a bit bigger. And never give up, whatever challenges there are in life for you. And don't forget, life is not always in your favor. There will be many failures also in life, which are fine as long as you can draw lessons and not to repeat those mistakes that you have made. Failure is a bad feeling, but never think, okay, this is what I can do, this is the utmost I can do, and I give up. No, there is always a better way of doing things. Never say to yourselves, this is what I can do, this is all I can have. No, you can always have even slightly more, even slightly better, and that should be your aim in life. When doing this, make sure two things. Life should be a fair play. So when you are reaching out to those dreams of yours, make sure that you are not harming or killing the dreams of other people. Dreams should live together in this world. And we should join our dreams so that we can reach even better dreams. Never forget that no living being is superior to another. We're all equals. And learn how to understand, how to respect your peers from a very young age. That is why we are here. We are going to show you how we live in Turkey so that you understand a bit of Turkey. And then maybe in the future when you have the opportunity, you go to Turkey, you see with your own eyes what we are going to show you today, and then you have a better dialogue with the Turkish people. Try to understand, put yourselves in the shoes of other people to understand their positions, their difficulties, their hatred, their anger. Even understanding the reasons of one's hatred is important so that you can one day try to eliminate that anger or hatred. Never judge people by looking from a distance. Try to understand. This is, I think, the way to being a good person. I shouldn't be too long, I think, because I have my colleagues who are very eager to tell a bit more about Turkey. As part of our embassy's responsibilities, we also promote academic and education exchanges. And Turkish government provides every year scholarships at university level. Since you're high school graduates, I presume you're either graduating very soon or in a few years at most. So I will leave with Madam Principal brief notes about Turkish scholarships. It is a full scholarship covering all your training expenses in Turkey, health insurance, travel expenses from Kenya to Turkey and back. And we have many Kenyans who have studied their university education in Turkey and are capable of speaking excellent Turkish, sometimes even better than me. Every year in the January-March period, the applications have to be made online. I've seen your ICT center, and I'm sure that you are using the computers perfectly well, so it should be, you know, a very simple thing for you to apply. There are certain documents that needed to be uploaded in the computer during the application. And after pre-screening of those applications, every year around April, Turkish Scholarship Council sends teams to Nairobi and they have face-to-face interviews. The good thing is these scholarships are so competitive. So if you work hard, if you're really good, if you make a strong case before the Scholarship Council members, then there is no reason why you cannot get a scholarship. We don't have quotas, so we don't say every year we give Kenya only 40 to 50 scholarships. The more successful applications there are, the more opportunities there are as well. So far, most of the scholarships we awarded went to the sectors of medicine because Turkey is really strong in medical training. Definitely Kenya needs good doctors, but know that there is more competition in medicine than other areas. And I'm sure some of you would like to be engineers, some of you would like to be teachers, some of you would like to be diplomats, international relations. So I encourage you to consider other subjects as well. So as of January next year, follow that website regularly. All the announcement, all the information will be there, and we're leaving anyway some brief notes to tell you more about Turkish scholarships. And I think I'll stop here. Thank you very much. It's a great pleasure. We didn't have much time, extensive time, to chat with you this time, but I'll be around during and after lunch. So if you have any questions, feel free to approach me, and I'll be very happy to answer. We trust in you as much as your own country, Kenya, trusts you. We trust that you will carry Kenya to higher levels, and that means higher levels for Turkish-Kenya relations as well. Thank you very much for the hospitality. Before I leave the stage, it's a very simple thing. These are the notes for scholarships, and we brought two very small packages for these girls. There are two games that they can play together. One is darts, the other is table tennis. Yes, table tennis. So, we're leaving the future.
Thank you very much, madam. I believe now we are not strangers with Turkey, isn't it?
Yes.
We are not strangers, we are sisters to Turkey. And one more thing that is very key, that maybe nobody has talked about, that you need to see, experience, and think about, is who is the ambassador to Turkey? Are we together? You can see it is a lady. Have you seen that?
Yes.
It is a what?
Amen.
Have you learned something from that?
Yes.
That is actually, that was the major lesson that we wanted to learn today. That was the greatest lesson. So that we see that there are no limits in as far as careers and professions are concerned. There are no limits. Like she has said, don't limit yourself. Do not limit yourself. So I wish to once again, maybe just very briefly, recognize the presence of Elimu TV, and maybe just ask Madam Jane to greet you so that she can also tell you that in the evening or tomorrow, this will be featured in Elimu TV.
Thank you so much, Madam Principal, Madam Ambassador. Thank you so much again for honoring this invitation. My name is Jane Muthiga, the director and founder of Elimu TV, as you know. Elimu is a TV channel that broadcasts education, and I know it's a channel that most of you have tuned in, and most of you have learned through. How many have tuned in to Elimu? Thank you so much. We partner with your school, and I'm so delighted to the Madam Principal that she agreed to our invitation to be part of our partner, and where we started by doing content. Your girls, Madam Ambassador, produced very good content for mathematics. So if you go to Elimu website, you'll see Tumu Tumu girls teaching mathematics. From your own?
Yes.
That is very good. We are taking that program further because we now have a program called Content Developers Club. And the Content Developers Club, we are inviting teachers, we are inviting students, and anybody who can have content that they can share that is education related. We need to come back and actually bring out the science, the presentation that were done out there, we need to come back and now capture them for purpose of teaching, and I know the girls will do very well, isn't it? I'm also happy to say that now we have got the video on demand. Video on demand is a platform whereby you can just go and capture the video that you want to see or to learn from. And we have uploaded over 500 videos and at a very small fee of 20 shillings per video, so that we are able to reach out to as many students as possible. And now Edimu is streaming. I looked at your computer lab and I said, are you aware that Edimu is streaming? You can now watch Edimu through your computer. You can watch Edimu through your mobile phone. So when you go back home, please make sure that you tune into Edimu, even if you are out of Nairobi or the areas that we are reached. But progressively, we are planning to be national. So I'm so happy that you've continued to be with us. Last time we had some other girls coming to Edimu office. The other time we went to the ambassador's office, and today we are here, and we are going to do more and more things. So thank you so much, and as I sit down, I want to ask our principal just to say hi. He's a note teacher, to say hi to the girls, and asanteni sana. So how do you do a shout out for him, isn't it? So girls, do a shout out for us. Yeah.
Habari ya Tumu Tumu. Oh, thank you. I am David William Mwenaina, principal Elimu TV. I'll be very brief because I'm a motivational speaker and sometimes I extend too much. I only want to leave you with one word that you'll always remember. The most important thing that makes us very successful in what you want to do in life is first of all to believe in yourself. Can we say, I believe in myself?
I believe in myself.
That I can be able to do great things?
That I can be able to do great things.
And there are no limitations?
And there are no limitations.
May God help me do so.
May God help me do so.
Who can repeat that? Okay, one girl to come and just ahead of the others and just say it, and then I'll sit down. I just want to believe that you'll always remember that quotation. Who can volunteer? Ah, yes. Just come in front.
I believe in myself that I can do very great things with no limitations. May God help me so. Now you repeat after me.
I hope maybe next time I can have a longer platform to talk to you maybe for just about an hour with the permission of the principal. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Maybe before we continue, I'm looking at the school captain to ceremoniously come and receive these gifts. They belong to you. And I do not want to receive them. They are not mine, they are yours. So, I met to present the same to our school captain. Our school captain is Hannah. She is in Form 4, just about to sit for a KCSE. And she works together with all these girls to make Tumu Tumu Girls what it is. So thank you very much. God bless. Thank you. So from here, we are
now moving to the next session, which is going to be very brief. That is, we need to entertain our guests, isn't it? We need to do some piece of entertainment so that even as she goes back to her office and her home, she will remember that she met beautiful girls who are not just bored. They can also do what? Entertain. They can multitask. They are good in sciences. They are good in mathematics. They are good in music. They are good in all those things. And I hand over the mic, because I'm not very good at that, I hand over the mic to Mr. Mathenge. Thank you.
Let us appreciate again our ambassador. Thank you, madam. Let us appreciate also Elimu TV. There's something that you can see that today we are having is Ladies Day. The ambassador, she's a lady. Elimu TV, the founder. Yes. Our principal.
I'm
not for me. Now, we all. This particular time, through your permission, madam, we request to present the best of Tumu Tumu girls that we've done. These are teams that has moved. They are going to the regional competitions. Last year, they have also moved to the national competitions, and they are simply the best. So I have this particular time, Mr. Njuguna, to present to us the first team that is presenting the entertainment. Mr. Njuguna. Yes, Mr. Njuguna. Let us appreciate Mr. Njuguna. Mr. Njuguna, the coordinator of last particular session.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mr. Njuguna.
Yeah, we are going to have a bit of entertainment, and I want to have the following girls to the Marshall Dom, the folk song, the folk dance, the trio, and finally we shall have our own Tara song.
So that's the team now getting in. So madam, as also part of the introduction of Tumu Tumu girls, I remember when we visited you with some girls, you asked me what is the meaning of Tumu Tumu. And I remember I explained to you that Tumu Tumu means is dry firewood from the local language meaning toko, tomo, tomo. That is small pieces of dry firewood. And if you look at, as you shall be getting outside here, you've got Tumu Tumu Hill. I know that's what the members from this community named Tumu Tumu girls as Toko Tumu Tumu, and meaning that we are strong. That means we are a very strong team. And also when we visited you, the embassy, I remember one of the girls presented to the rest of the girls how they ate very nice foods from Turkey. The culture of Turkey was explained to the girls. And as the team comes, I can see she is just here. So just come and tell the girls again what you got from, yes, just come and, let us appreciate her as she comes. Yes, just come and tell the girls how you felt and whether she is in Form 4 and whether you'll be the first person to apply for the scholarship, full scholarship. Yes, briefly.
Ambassador, our principal and all the invited guests, including my schoolmates. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name is Christine. I'm in 4B, and I want to remind you of how I felt when I attended. Okay, the place was nice. Not only the food, the place was nice. The hospitality. The way they welcomed us and the place was just wow. I wish next time we'll all have a bus there. We accommodate on the bus, then we go. But what we learned there, everything is possible if you just work hard. And there's one thing I remember. It's about their flag. Like us, our flag is black for our skin color. Now their flag is, they had a holy war. So, as in, everything to them, it's like everything is up there. So even us, even if we are strong, we'll be also up there in everything that we do. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mama Fitena. And you can see from that particular time, she has even grown. She is now bigger, tighter, full from Turkey. So, thank you so much, madam, for the invitation that you gave us. I don't know whether even next year, even other years, you're also going to, as she has requested, that you invite the whole school, a whole bus, and they come and visit you to see how things are done in Turkey. So, Mr. Jogona, now, I wish to welcome the team to present the first song. Coming in with drums, the best that you can get. Drum beating is one of the functional ceremonies that is associated with Africans, and the team that will present the first folk song.
Thank you.
thing I was doing, I don't even want to have a sister, that's the thing that she did when she was very young in her high school life. So this particular time, when I was sister, we reached out to the drum, the trio will be doing the drums. And as I said, it's good that we also speak and get what we can associate with as Africans. So the trio, just come on, the trio, they are girls who dance with a lot of passion, they communicate, the drum beating is one of the things that is little bit the Africans. Best of the best. Let's appreciate them at the start of. Yes.
Entertainers. state fair. Kenya. have magic, but I'm principal. Forget that, but I'm principal it. Yes. You see, when you go to Mombasa, you behave like Mombasa people, eh? This is what the principal was doing. That's what we are the principal again. Go to Turkey, then madam also you take us to Mombasa. Because you see that if you take you to Mombasa, you can really dance. Thank you so much. And even we are going to be inviting you in the assemblies to be dancing for us. There is a lot of, we have identified a talent somewhere. Thank you. So now, after this, thank you so much to the entertainment team, done by Mr. Joguna. Thank you so much, Mr. Joguna and Mr. Mwangi, and your team for that part of the entertainment. At this particular time, Madam Ambassador, we wish now to get to a presentation about facts about Turkey, because we agreed. And then the candidates, they were very keen when you're mentioning
to be able to talk to you. And thank you very much, Madam Principal, for your hospitality. Mr. Matenge, personally, I would like to thank you may not know this, but we've been texting before we here for 3 or 4 days to make the preparations, and Mr. Mandinga was really a great help. And Madam Ambassador, thank you for this opportunity as well, and my colleagues, I'd like to thank them for making this happen. I don't want to take too much of your time because we'll go to lunch and then we'll have a beautiful documentary about the cats of Istanbul. So I'll just give you some basic and hopefully fun facts about Turkey. And Turkey is called, maybe if we can go to the slide, Turkey is called Türkiye in Turkish. I don't know what it's called in Swahili yet, but maybe you can help me. Uturiki. So, as you can see, our country is at the crossroads of three continents, Africa, Asia, and Europe. And you can see our flag on the left-hand side, the white crescent and star before red background. And we'll move on to the next slide. Similarities between Turkey and Kenya start with their founding, actually. Although they were founded as independent republics at different moments in the 20th century, they were both founded by visionary leaders, which is a common feature for our countries, namely Atatürk, which you can see on the upper side of the slide, and Kenyatta, who both fought against imperial powers and transformed their countries into equal and respectable nations of the world. And in the next slide you can see that both Kenya and Turkey are medium-sized countries compared to much bigger countries like United States, China, India, and they approximately have an area, in the case of Kenya, 580,000 kilometers squared, and in the case of Turkey, 780 km². And our populations respectively for Kenya and Turkey are 47 million and 8 million. The diplomatic ties between our countries was established in 1967. That's the beginning of our embassy here. So this year we're actually celebrating the 50th anniversary of friendly relations between Turkey and Kenya. It's an honor to be able to celebrate it here with you. And although Turkey and Kenya are located in different hemispheres, as you can see, we are brought closer by direct flights every day from Istanbul to Nairobi. We also have direct and indirect flights between Istanbul and Mombasa. And currently, Turkey is the 17th biggest economy in the world and 6th biggest in Europe. Thank you. Our economic growth is
expected to continue in the years ahead, and it's one of our strategic objectives as a country.
Of hazelnuts in the world. Italy comes next with 20% of the production. And as you may all know, turkey is also the name of a bird. How did that happen? Well, let me explain. Fortunately, we were not named after the bird. The bird was named after us. So the reason behind this is that the Turkish merchants used to export from East Africa, actually, a bird called guinea fowl, which looked a lot like the North American bird, which we now call turkey. And turkey also gave name to a stone. It's called Pierre Turquoise in French, which means Turkish stone. Because once again, trade is the reason behind this. Turkish merchants provided the trade route for the stone, which was moved from Central Asia to Europe. So it all connects with the being crossroads in the middle of all three continents. It pays, you know, the stones and birds are named after your country. And this is another interesting fact. Turkey was the birthplace and home of Santa Claus. Well, not Santa Claus actually, but the man who gave rise to the legend itself. Saint Nicholas, a 14th century saint, Christian saint, who lived in Derme, which is now in the city of Antalya, on the southern coast of Turkey. He is considered to be the real historical figure because of his secret gift-giving tradition, the figure behind the myth of Santa Claus. And finally, Turkey is the home of the world-famous wine cat. I'm sure it's not as big as the cats in Africa, but the thing about them is that they are a very special breed of cat, and according to legend, they were aboard Noah's Ark, you know, the biblical Noah's Ark. And they then swam shore near Mount Are, the highest mountain in Turkey, in the eastern part of Turkey. Interestingly, and the legend also attests this, they, unlike other cats, they are natural born swimmers, and they have, as you can see from the slide, odd colored eyes. They are an endangered species, which are currently under special protection. And I will stop here and show you some clips about Turkish language, Turkish landscape, and some more fun facts about Turkey. Then after lunch, we'll see a movie about the close cousins of the one cat, the cats of Istanbul. Thank you very much for listening, and thank you very much for all the great questions.
Let's appreciate Mr. Mehmet Can. Yes, and as Mr. Mehmet said, we've been communicating with him, so I know the first thing that you'll be going to Turkey, I'll be there at the front. So I'll be there, you'll find me there, I'll receive you in the airport, I'll be there. Especially the phone calls, please come to Turkey, because I'm also now a member, I'm a Turkish. In fact, I'm going to apply for citizenship through the ambassador is here. So after this, then from there, you'll get me there. How many phone calls are getting me there now in Turkey? How many phone calls? Yeah. Very good. Those are phone calls. We are coming to Turkey. Especially to Istanbul, the largest city in Turkey. Yeah, or the capital, Ankara. We shall be there. I'll ask Madam Ambassador, as she lives, to get me a place, one of the beautiful mansions, so that you get me there. And I'll host you as one of the members of that country. So at this particular time, we glad because of the far that you moved. And yes, that's what we expect in the afternoon. Also a number of other things. And about the straight cuts, so that's what we expect in the afternoon after lunch, Mr. Mehmet. Are you going to do it now? Now, very good. Carry on.
Excuse me, I'm going to check it out. I'd like to sit down.
My name is Shana.
And my name is Chan.
We are your companions on this journey. Before we get started, we would like to introduce ourselves briefly. Well, we are cheerful and funny.
And we like to make friends.
And you? Do you recognize us from somewhere? Yes, if you have ever been to Turkey, then you certainly have seen our relatives. I am Can, we are the blue glass eye. That is one way of putting it.
We are made of glass, and people in Turkey believe we have protective power to look after those who keep us with them.
That's why you see many people in Turkey carrying us with them, be it on their clothes, on a chain, or on their bags. The Turkish language belongs to the Euro-Altaic language family. It is easy to learn, if you ask me, but I have been learning it since I was born. Did you know that Turkish is spoken by 150 million people around the world?
The Turkish language is very old and belongs to the Euro-Altaic language.
Let's appreciate the team once again, the technical team. I know now from now you understand a lot about Turkey, even some of the words,
yeah.
Like how to say hello,
yeah.
How to say a different one, ilkame. I don't know what I'm saying, but I know a lot from Turkey, I know many of the things. So after this, we're going to have our lunch break, because this was a trailer of the movie that you expect in the afternoon, a documentary of what you expect in the afternoon. And Madam Ambassador, in our school, we have named our streams in terms of the planets. We have got the five of them. We have Venus, we have got Jupiter, Mars, Neptune, and Pluto. And at this particular time, from Venus School, I would like to invite one of us to come and have the grace before meals that we break for lunch. None other than Gladys Jamio. Makofia, Gladys, as she comes to the grace before meals. So we can rise. We can rise there.
Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we humble ourselves for thy presence. We thank you for this chance to agree on us, O God, and we pray that you may make maximum opportunity, O God. We pray that even as we go to take our lunch, O God, you may bless it, O God, and it may be a blessing to our bodies, O God. We also pray for those who don't have, that you may provide for them. Thank you. And thank you, O God, for this we do pray, trust in your holy name.
Amen.
Thank you. Before we break, we take, which is already 1:10, so we take 30 minutes kindly because the guest will be leaving. By 1:40, we should be here, settled, so that we go to the next part, so that we give the guest a chance. Thank you. It has been a good day. Good day. Ambassador and the principal now, this time now, the ambassador and the principal alone. Just stop and say it has been a good day. Thank you. So, thank you so much, Mr. Mehmet and your team, for such a nice documentary. I know you've learned much about cats.
Yeah.
I know you've learned that we can also live together with other animals.
Yeah.
I don't know how, if it was in Nairobi, for example. And those cats were roaming all over. What would you have just done? For example, when you are going for a beach town the other day, you'll be going for a beach town and you find a cat in the streets of Nairobi. What would you do? So I think from today now, you've learned that you can live with the cats. We learned that these cats, some of them, they don't have even a caretaker, but God is still providing something for them. Have you seen that? That you don't have to worry even in life, there is a lot that you can. And I think even those students who are taking history, there's a lot that you can learn from Turkey. For the history students, you know about the World Wars. You know that Turkey was one of the members of the Central Powers. Alongside other members like Austria-Hungary and the rest. So from here, by BYU, I will go direct to the History Evolving World Book 4. Check more about the Central Powers. take more about what was the role of Turkey, what was the role of Turkey in this, in us, the area of the Central Powers. So because of time, we now wish to come to the end of the session. I wish that we give the 5 factorials for Mr. Mehmet and his team for that documentary. 5, is that 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you.